हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज द केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कैलकुलेशन. ओके, नाउ स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कैलकुलेशन इज द कैलकुलेशन बेस्ड ऑन बैलेंस केमिकल इक्वेशन इज कॉल्ड एज स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कैलकुलेशन. द स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कैलकुलेशन इज द कैलकुलेशन विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द बैलेंस केमिकल इक्वेशन इज कॉल्ड एज स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कैलकुलेशन. ओके, नाउ बैलेंस केमिकल इक्वेशन, द बैलेंस केमिकल इक्वेशन इज द सिंबॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन. द बैलेंस केमिकल इक्वेशन इज द सिंबॉलिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द केमिकल रिएक्शन. ओके, नाउ लेट्स कंसिडर फॉर एग्जाम्पल ट्वाइस एनो react with oxygen gives twice NO2. Twice NO2. This is the chemical reaction. This is the chemical reaction or equation. Okay. Now, the balance chemical equation of this chemical reaction is the twice NO gaseous react with gaseous oxygen to gives gases twice NO2. This is the balance chemical equation. The calculation based on a balance chemical equation is called as stoichiometric calculation, and the balance chemical equation is the symbolic representation of chemical reaction is called as balance chemical equation. Okay, now balance chemical equation gives the following information which is useful in a solving of a problem which is based on a chemical reaction. The balance chemical equation is useful, or it gives a following information which is useful in a solving of a problem which is based on the chemical reaction. Okay, now the following information is the first point. The balance chemical equation indicates the number of moles of a reactant involved and number of moles of product formed in a chemical reaction. The balance chemical equation indicates the number of moles of reactant, number of moles of reactant involved in a chemical reaction, and the number of moles of product formed in a chemical reaction. Okay, now second information, it indicate the relative masses of a reactant and product. The balance chemical equation indicates the relative masses of a reactant and product. Okay, now next, third point or third information, the balance chemical equation indicates the relationship between the volume of gaseous reactant and product at a standard temperature and pressure. Third point, the balance chemical equation indicates the relationship between volume of a gaseous reactant and product at a standard temperature and pressure. Okay, now next point, stoichiometric problem. There are three types of stoichiometric problem. There are three types of stoichiometric problem. First, the problem based on mass-mass relationship. First type, the problem based on mass-mass relationship. Okay, now second type of a stoichiometric problem is the problem based on mass volume relationship. The problem based on mass volume relationship. And third type is the problem based on volume relationship, volume relationship. Third type of stoichiometric problem is the problem based on volume relationship. Okay, now next point, step involved in a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation. The steps involved in a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation. Okay, now first Write down the balanced chemical equation representing the chemical reaction. First point. First step of problem based on a stoichiometric calculation. Okay. Now first step. Write down the balanced chemical equation representing the chemical reaction. Okay. Now next. Write down the relative masses, number of moles and value of a reactant and product below their formula. Second step of the problem based on the stoichiometric calculation is the write down the number of moles, relative masses or value of a reactant and product below their formula. Okay. Now third, calculate the relative masses or value of a reactant and product from their formula. Third point, calculate the masses and value of a reactant and product from their formula. Okay. And fourth step is the fourth step of a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation is the apply the unitary method to calculate the known factor which is required by the problem. Fourth step of a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation is the apply the unitary method to calculate the unknown factor which is required by the problem. Okay. Now first point, chemical reaction and stoichiometric calculation. Okay. Now calculation based on the balanced chemical equation is called as stoichiometric calculation. Okay. Now balanced chemical equation is the symbolical representation of a chemical reaction. Balanced chemical reaction is the symbolical representation of chemical reaction. The balanced chemical equation gives the following information which is useful in a solving of a problem which is based on the chemical reaction. This following information is the first point. It indicates the number of moles of reactant involved in a chemical reaction and number of moles of product formed in a chemical reaction. Okay. Now second, it indicates the relative masses of reactant and product. Okay. Now third, it indicates the relationship between volume of a gaseous reactant and product. Okay. Now next, stoichiometric problem. There are three types of stoichiometric problem. First, the problem based on mass-mass relationship. Second type, the problem which is based on mass-volume relationship. And third type is the problem based on the volume-volume relationship. Okay. Now next type or next point, step involved in a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation. Okay. Now first step is the write down the balanced chemical equation representing the chemical reaction. First of all, write down the balanced chemical equation representing the chemical reaction. Okay. Now second, write down the number of moles, relative masses or value of a reactant and product below their formulae. Write down the number of moles, relative masses or value of a reactant and product below their formulae. Okay. Now third point or third step, calculate the relative masses or value of a reactant and product from their formulae. And fourth point or fourth step is the apply the unitary method to calculate the unknown factor which is required by the problem. Okay. Okay. The next point is the stoichiometric calculation or numericals or problem. That is first problem. What weight of a calcium oxide will be formed on heating of 19.3 gram of calcium carbonate? The atomic weight or atomic masses of a calcium is 40, atomic weight of carbon is 12 and atomic weight of oxygen is 16. Okay. Now first write down the weight of calcium carbonate. That is 19.3 gram. 19.3 gram. Okay. Now steps involved in a problem based on a stoichiometric calculation. The first point or first step is the write down the balanced chemical equation representing the chemical reaction. First of all, write down the balanced chemical equation. Okay. Now balanced equation is the calcium carbonate, solid calcium carbonate heated to give calcium oxide solid and carbon dioxide gaseous. Gaseous carbon dioxide. Okay. Now, second step is write down their masses. Write down the masses of a reactant and product below their formulae. Okay. Now, mass of calcium carbonate is 100 gram. The mass of a calcium carbonate is calculated by using a atomic weight. Okay. Now atomic weight of calcium is 40. Okay. Plus atomic weight of carbon is 12. And then the atomic weight of oxygen is 16. 16 into 3, that is 48. The total is 100. Gram. Okay. The mass of calcium carbonate is 100 gram. Okay. The mass of calcium oxide is 56 gram and mass of carbon dioxide is 44 gram. 44 gram. Okay. 40 plus 16, that is 56 gram. That is mass of calcium oxide. Okay. Now, carbon 12, oxygen 16, 16 into 2, that is 32, 32 plus 12, that is 44 gram. This is the atomic, this is the mass of carbon dioxide. Okay. Now, the 100 gram of calcium carbonate, 100 gram of calcium carbonate produce 56 gram of calcium oxide. 56 gram of calcium oxide. Okay. Now therefore 19.3 gram of calcium carbonate produce what gram of calcium oxide? 19.3 gram of calcium carbonate produce of gram of calcium oxide. Gram of calcium oxide. Okay. Cross multiplication. Okay. That is 19.3 gram into 56 gram divided by 100 gram. Solve this equation, we get the final answer, that is 10.8 gram of calcium oxide, that is 19.3 gram of calcium carbonate produce 10.8 gram of calcium oxide. Okay.